Your introduction needs to be short, interesting, and exciting. In this video, I'll be sharing 7 simple steps to help you introduce yourself whenever you join an online course. Step number 1 is greet your audience with enthusiasm. I know this one sounds pretty obvious, but your greeting can be easily overlooked. Especially if you decide to type in your introduction instead of uploading an intro video. So put your best smile and your best emoji on and greet your audience with enthusiasm. Step number 2 is express your excitement for this opportunity. It would be really nice if you could start from a place of gratitude. Here, we're covering 2 main points. You're expressing your excitement for having the opportunity to study this course, and you're expressing your excitement for being a part of this amazing community. We're all looking for connection after all. So take the first step and initiate that connection. Step number 3 is share your name to the group. If you happen to have a shortened version of your name and you want to give this community permission to call you by your short name, this is your chance. To keep things nice, short, and sweet, make sure you do all of that in one sentence. Step 4 is where things start to look delicious. Step 4 is basically your essence. This is your opportunity to share your passions using one sentence. By sharing your passions, you're giving your peers the opportunity to identify some common areas of interest and hopefully help them see how you can collaborate and work together in future. After you've shared your passions, step number 5 is all about sharing what you hope to learn from that online course. Some of us might have a super long list of things we hope to learn from that online course. If that's you, make sure you cap your desired learning outcomes to a maximum of 3 bullet points. After you've greeted your audience with enthusiasm, share your name, your passions, and what you're hoping to learn from that course, chances are someone in the group has already started to find some common areas of interest. But just in case they haven't, I have one last tip to help you make a meaningful connection and introduction. Step number 6 is where you're currently based. If you no longer live in the same city or country that you were born in, then you may share both where you were born and where you're currently based. For the sake of simplicity though, where you're currently based does the job just fine. And who knows, you might even find a local support or study group in your area. And finally, step number 7 is your clothes. For your introduction to have any sort of impact, you need to be able to start a conversation. And that's exactly what step 7 is all about. Step number 7 is all about asking one open-ended question. If you skip this step, you're basically talking yourself out of getting some great and interesting conversation started. Next time you join an online community or an online course, remember these 7 steps. And make sure you implement them. Now, if you're one of those people who learns better with examples, in my next video, I'll put these 7 steps into practice. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have, let me know in the comments below. Hit that like button and click subscribe. Have an amazing day, and I'll see you on the next one.